what, though? It's funny that this building is like that. I was just watching or doing some more studies on the spot that I left from down south. And they were talking about the Conestoga wagons and the different houses that were built a certain way. And you could tell by how these houses was built what their nationality was.
Whoa.
Yeah, fact.
Giving that up?
They was giving it up like that.
And I'm looking at an authentic 1688 house from Germany. It came from the Palatinate region, which is the exact same region where many of the early settlers of Rowan County came from. It is a wattle and daub house, which means that it had an exterior timber frame filled in by mud and cement. It was then whitewashed to look like you see here. Most of our ancestors who were German would recognize this house as being something their family might once have lived in.
And they said
architectural aspect of identifying.
Yes. And this was right here in North America, bro. And they said that today some of these buildings would be unrecognized because of how they painted over them.
Yeah.
And they said that they were quote unquote whitewashed by painting them white. So when I'm looking at this white stone right here, white concrete, I'm thinking like, yeah, you know what I mean? Cause remember, they the brutish Moors burnt the White House too.
The War of 1812 would have to do with the burning of Washington, D.C. It's interesting how that is not really part of our image of anything that ever happened to the United States. I think we kind of liked to forget it. But the British did, during the war, sail up the Potomac, landed some forces, defeated the Americans outside of Washington, and marched right into Washington. The images of that are some remarkable ones. They went to what we now call the White House, went in, there was a meal left on the table by a fleeing Dolly Madison. They ate the meal, they went into the congressional chambers of the time and had a fake congressional meeting in which they discussed whether or not to burn the chambers and voted yes. Went ahead and burned them. And it was pretty humiliating, to say the least. Both Madison, President Madison and his wife.
And these is brownstones, burnt stones.
Yeah, they painted it white as a result.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, this was the aspect of quote-unquote whitewashing or erasing certain history, you know what I mean? Or imagery of history. God damn. Oh, yeah. You know what? I rode past this joint so many times and was inspired, bro. Now we here, I know this is Moorish architecture. What they call it, St. Patrick's Church or something like that?
Yeah. There's old Moorish, St. Patty.
Yes, it is called St. Patrick's Church. Quick message. In the series Power, they was subconsciously, they was giving it to you. I mean, they had a melanated Moor with the appellation or name St. Patrick. All right. That's not a coincidence. I highly suggest that you read the book Ancient and Modern Britons, Volume 1. Find out who the original Irish were. And honestly, we could take it a step further than that and say that, you know, St. Patrick wasn't even his real name.
St. Patrick wasn't Patrick or Irish. Maewen Sukat was born in 5th century Roman Britain or modern day Scotland. Born into a Christian family, he was not a devout believer, but after being kidnapped as a teen and held in slavery for many years, he later changed his name when dedicating himself to Christianity.
On top of that, for St. Patrick's Day. The color wasn't originally green, it was blue.
St. Patrick was originally associated with blue. Some say the political exhibition of national pride in the 1798 Irish Rebellion sparked the conversion to green.
So shout out Blue Pill.
Set.
For the sisters into tarot, there goes your seven of swords, right on the door, right on the door.
Huh. Oh, this is a closed room here. Ill. I had the mic and I did an interview with Red and
they come out.
My audio sounds sucky as hell. Like,
let me see if we can.
Yeah. It'll be way better on this one though. Mm-hmm. It'll be way better without it. Whoa. Tweaking, or are we looking at? We looking at a Moorish image or what, bro? Nah. I mean, compared to the other ones, you don't think that's?
Oh, yeah. This is probably a little more Eastern European. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because I'm looking at the headdress over here, and the more Eastern European.
Yeah, but I mean, they're eccentric.
That's Eastern European lady of Sekhtawa shrine, whatever that's dealing with Eastern European. Right. See the Polish insignia underneath there.
Yeah.
And they're the ones most of them can find is going to have information.
That's a Moorish woman, bro.
It's one of the oldest icons of the Blessed Virgin in the world. You know what I'm saying? So you know the older that you get.
Mm-hmm.
Pride at third time.
Holy Family of Nazareth, 26 AD. So this family, hold on, Constantinople,
will remain for centuries. Memory by the elders. The holy picture reached Southern Poland as part of a dowry and a marriage. The holy picture reached Southern Poland as part of a dowry and a marriage.
I say that all white people were had slaves, right? You cannot say that. Only people that conquered, they colonized the world, and they destroyed your peoples were German, French, English, German, and Spanish, German, and German, Italians.
No.
Polish people had anything to do with slavery.
Germans is conquered.
The holy picture reached Southern Poland as part of a dowry and a marriage between Patrick. This guy.
Yo, this is where I'm talking about.
Yo, is this the whole get down, bro? So, I mean, we know for a fact that the pilgrims, the Europeans, they got everything from us. You know what I mean? I still think the picture next door was a woman, a Moorish woman. But look. With everything that's going on right now, right? They say, quote unquote, black identity extremists, all of this is going on. Farrakhan gave a speech wherein he touched on some of these things. And my question to you, you know what I'm saying, is do you think he went too far left or too out there by saying that he converted to Jesus and that Elijah Muhammad is Jesus?
I want you to put up the real Jesus. Put him up on the screen. Allahu Akbar. Go ahead, dear. Yes, sir. Allahu Akbar. That's my Jesus. That's the man that saved me. And every one of these can testify that Jesus can save. That's why I look like a young man, though I'm an old man, because I met Jesus.
Because, I mean, when we look in the 101s, Noble Drew Ali is saying that Jesus means justice.
In the book of John, Jesus said many things about who he is.
Right.
I am the good shepherd.
That's right.
I am the door.
Go ahead.
That's right.
I am the true vine. My Father is the husband.
That's right.
He talks about I am the way, the truth, and the life.
Go ahead.
Good God Almighty. Then in Revelation he said, I am the resurrection and the life.
Yeah.
Whosoever believes in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. That's Jesus.
That's right.
But he never said, I am a Christian.
That's right. That's right, beloved. Never.
I think I'll take a little walk.
Go ahead.
And walk back.
What did you take away from that when he was talking about
Farrakhan? You know what I'm saying? Has always been deeply religious. Mm-hmm. You know, my grandfather knew him as a young man before he came into the nation.
Mm-hmm.
And he has an Episcopalian background in church. You know what I mean? And I think that, you know, when he speaks of Jesus, I think that he's speaking highly of, you know, with Masonic symbolism.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So I think that the lens through which he approaches spirituality is a religious one. Mm-hmm. So he's always going to look at his master teacher as a Jesus figure, same as he looks at himself as a Jesus figure. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
He's still here, so he still has to edify, you know, somebody and put them in that status as opposed to him being in that status. mm-hmm. initially. And then, you know, I'm going back to last year with the Million Man March. People were, mm-hmm. I mean, 2 years ago, was it?
Yeah.
Not quite sure, but they were saying, you know, he was very inclusive of multiple denominations, you know mm-hmm. what I'm saying, and his committee and how he set things up.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, people were saying that that was strategy for mm-hmm. him to reach over the aisle because he's more of a public figure, you know what I'm saying? So he has the ability to bring Christians in and not just Muslims or radicals or people that are going to end up on the BIE list and things mm-hmm. of that nature. So they said that this man can reach across the aisle, almost like a politician, and bring other people to the information, you know? So that was the excuse that was given then, you know what I'm saying? We got to remember, even with Reverend Moon, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, when he brought that denomination in,
yeah.
he sees a lot of similarities between his organizations and Christianity because he's in the leadership position.
Yeah.
I can't recall personally if I ever heard Elijah Muhammad refer to himself as Jesus
right.
or to his organization as a quasi-Christian organization.
Right.
But under the leadership of Farrakhan, we can identify that this is not a shot.
Right, not at all.
I think that you are who you are, you know what I'm saying? And I would be very careful by saying that in his leadership that he has deviated somewhat from the initial instructions of his teacher to veer it more in line with what he sees. But there has been things that he's done that has come into question, you know what I'm saying, in regards to saying for the original this is not what he mandated, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And it's more like, you know, Farrakhan taking things into his own hands, saying, this is what I'm mandating, you know what I'm saying? I'm in a leadership position, and all leaders should, you feel me?
Right.
They should modify their approach towards certain things to align with the times, mm-hmm. and they have to be political, you know what I'm saying? So the politics of the day would be, yeah, he probably has to make some friends or some allies, you know what I'm saying? But the idea, you know, the ideology altogether, changing the ideology of the approach altogether and
yeah.
making it more Christian-based, I think that's more in line and more in lead with who he is and what his spirit is.
Right.
And again, that's not to take anything from him because
mm-hmm.
the lens and through which we look at society unfortunately, a Christian base, we live in a Jesus Christ's narrative.
Put the Jesus that they say is Jesus. There he is. Oh, don't he look beautiful? The real Jesus didn't look like that.
No, sir.
That's their imagination of Jesus.
Mm-hmm.
You feel me?
Yeah.
So, even, you know what I'm saying? Like he said, when Drew Ali came with a level of religiosity because he wanted to reach the Negro, Black, and color of that particular time.
Mm-hmm.
So he had to speak their language. Elijah did the same thing. But they came with variations because they were speaking about a whole nother religion, ourself, Lord and Master.
Yeah.
You dig what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So why would Farrakhan abandon that?
Yeah. This music sound like the same stuff they be playing on Halloween and shit.
Hey.
Yeah, how about that one?
What time is it? They going to service and shit?
I think so. You want to do the outside steps?
If you got enough scenes from here.
Oh, we could still get some more scenes. Definitely. I think that Moore's woman speak the volumes right there.
Okay, we're gonna get a clip of that. I just wanna shoot this real quick.
Yeah, absolutely. So they dealing with candle magic.
Yeah, candle dressing.
Yep. Yeah, all of that.
All of it.
They dealing with that right in the church. Right. As they call it, right in the church. And this is definitely old Moorish building. All of this Moorish architecture, look at this. Yes, none of that.
These are Basilica cathedrals, and all of this comes from Moorish Spain.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I'm trying to get nothing.
Yeah. Notice the arches over there, it's like shaped like the bishop's mitre and what. Am I tripping or are they brown skin? I see some brown skins over there.
Thank you. Letter from George Washington to Muhammad ibn Abdullah, Sultan of Morocco, City of New York, December the 1st, 1789. And he's wearing his Masonic garb, standing on the floor of Osar Set. Those black and white tiles represent Osar and Set, the upper world, the lower world. Are we clear? All right, and the G stands for geometry. And these, that compass in the square is referred to in the Bible as the carpenter's tools. And Jesus was a carpenter, you understand? Good. All right, now, anyway.
God give me style, God give me grace.
God give me style, God give me grace.
God put a smile on my face.
God put the smile on my face.
God make me shine like the sun.
God make me shine like the sun.
Sometimes I feel like I'm the one.
Sometimes I feel like
it ain't
the one.
My fault.
I just reach for style. I'm hot, I break it down.
It ain't my fault.
You can't break it down the way I break it down. Listen, you can call me what you want, black and ugly, but you can't convince me the Lord don't love me. When my CDs drop, they sell the best. You call it luck, why can't it just be I'm blessed? I'm a track star running through life, chasing my dreams. Best deal I made was trading the mic for that triple beam. I zone off thinking, is there really heaven or hell? If so, what happens to a changed man that dies in a cell? I need no answers to these questions, cause time will tell. Got a date with destiny, she's more than a girl. Don't much good come from me, but my music is a gift given from God, so I'ma use it, yeah.
God give me style, God give me grace.
God give me style, God give me grace.
God put a smile on my face.
God put the smile on my face.
God make me shine like the sun.
God make me shine like the sun.
Sometimes I feel like I'm the one.
Sometimes I feel like
it ain't my fault.
I just reach for style. I'm hot, I breaks it down.
It ain't my fault.
You can't break it down the way I break it down. Some days I'm in the crowd all by myself. Bunches around, I'm still by myself. I drift off on a cloud by myself. Think about nothing more than life, what else? These days it's hard to tell who really cares for me. So when you hear this song, you should say a prayer for me. I put a message in my music, hope it brightens your day. If times are hard when you're here, know you'll be okay. An OG told me God's favorites have a hard time. You have the hood, that's good. Now stay on the grind. I'm a sponge, knowledge and wisdom, I exhort fast. I'm in the class by myself, you do the math.
God give me style, God give me grace.
God give me style, God give me grace.
God put a smile on my face.
God put the smile on my face.
God make me shine like the sun.
God make me shine like the sun.
Sometimes I feel like I'm the one.
Sometimes I feel like
it
I'm
ain't
the one.
Fault.
Yeah.